Okay, so today we're going to talk about bottled and bond and that process. I brought out Henry McKenna because I think we all know that I love Heaven Hill Distillery at this point. So this is a great example of bottled and bond. So let's talk about the process. Back in the late 1800s, bottled or whiskey and American whiskey was really not standardized and pretty low quality. You could buy it in barrels, it could be grain whiskey in column stills and then blended with caramel and any other kind of colorings or flavorings. And so the government decided to standardize whiskey as kind of like the first Consumer Protection Act for whiskey. So there's four main rules that a bottled and bond whiskey has to go through. One, it has to be bottled at 100 proof, as you can see there. It has to be aged in a bonded warehouse. It has to be distilled by one single distiller in a single distillery in one single season. And it has to be aged at least 4 years. And so that was the standards that they put on bottled and bond whiskey. Unfortunately, it went out of favor in the 70s and the 80s, but you're seeing a big comeback now with the whiskeys. And it's really, really good. Rittenhouse is another great example. Old Forester does one now. Jim Beam has one. There's a bunch out there now. But Henry McKenna, if you can get your hands on this.